Chapter 1, Intro. Hello everyone, and welcome to the channel. I'm Martin, and I turn smart home chaos into slightly more organized chaos. Today, we're taking a closer look at the SONOFF SNZB-02P Zigbee Temperature and Humidity Sensor. Chapter 2, Disclaimer. Before we begin, a quick disclaimer. The voice you're hearing isn't mine. My natural diction isn't the clearest, so to make everything easier to follow, I've used AI-generated narration. That said, this is the only AI-generated part of the video. Also, this video is not sponsored. I wasn't paid to review this sensor, and SONOFF didn't send it to me for free. I bought 3 SONOFF SNZB-02P sensors in September 2024 on AliExpress for a total of £25.34, with free shipping. The parcel arrived in under a week. Not bad at all. Chapter 3. What's in the box? Let's begin with the ceremonial unboxing. Here is what you get in the box. One compact sensor with a magnetic back and a pre-installed battery. A metal plate for magnetic mounting. A 3M adhesive pad and a small screw for flexible mounting options. A quick start guide in multiple languages, including English. Here are some specifications from manufacturer. Chapter 4, Add Sensor to Network. It's time to give our climate sensor a job and connect it to the Zigbee network. Here's a step-by-step guide using Zigbee 2 MQTT. Step 1, Pair the sensor. Open the Zigbee 2 MQTT integration page and click the Permit Join button to open the gates of your Zigbee kingdom. Remove the battery insulation sheet from your SNZB-02P to power it on. Most Zigbee devices enter pairing mode automatically when powered on for the first time. But if yours is feeling a bit shy, give it a gentle nudge. Press and hold the pairing button on the side of the sensor for 5 seconds, until the red LED begins flashing slowly. Within a few seconds, the device should appear in your Zigbee 2 MQTT device list. Once your new device is visible in the list, disable join mode to prevent other devices from connecting unintentionally. Step 2. Name your new device. A newly added Zigbee device in Home Assistant may initially appear offline. This is often just a visual glitch in Zigbee 2 MQTT, where the device is actually connected, but its online status isn't displayed correctly. Renaming the device usually resolves this and updates its status to online. A clear, meaningful name helps keep your smart home organized and makes managing your devices much easier. For example, I named mine SNTH Kitchen Microwave. Here is what that stands for. SN for sensor, TH for temperature and humidity, kitchen, its location, and microwave, its noble resting place. Before saving, make sure to tick Update Home Assistant Entity ID so the new name is reflected throughout Home Assistant. Need help with naming conventions? Check out my video, The Perfect Naming Conventions? Simplify your smart home. Click the link in the top right corner or find it in the description below. Step 3. Customize settings. Once your sensor is paired and named, find it in the Zigbee 2 MQTT device list and click on it to open the device settings. Under the About tab, you can rename the device and add a description. Under Settings Specific tab, you can calibrate the temperature and humidity readings and adjust the precision of the reported values. Step 4. Location and labels. Now switch over to Home Assistant settings and click on Devices and Services. Open the Devices tab and find your newly added sensor. Click on it, then tap the pencil icon in the top right corner to enter edit mode. Assign it to the appropriate room. Add descriptive labels to help keep things tidy and easy to track. When you're done, click Update. And that's it. Chapter 5. Temperature and Humidity Validation. This is just a humble little sensor, not exactly mission control hardware, but we still want to make sure it does what it promises. Start by opening the sensor again in Home Assistant and checking whether both entities, temperature and humidity, are available. They should be, unless the sensor is faulty. Next, I wanted to test how accurate this thing really is, but unfortunately, I don't have any professional tools to help with that. So instead, I placed my old trusted temperature and humidity sensor right next to the new one and let them sit side by side for a few hours.
2 hours later.
Time to compare the readings. They should be identical or at least very close. My old reliable sensor shows exact 25 degrees Celsius and 46.9% humidity. The new SNZB-02P reads 25.0 degrees Celsius and 49.8% humidity. The temperature? Identical on both sensors. That's good enough for me, but the humidity? Not quite there yet. To calibrate the sensor, I went into the Zigbee 2 MQTT integration, opened the Settings Specific tab, and made the necessary adjustments. All changes are saved automatically. Now, let's give it a minute or two.
A while later.
Time for a second round of comparison. The old sensor still shows 25.0 degrees Celsius and 46.9% humidity. SNZB-02P now reads 25.0 degrees Celsius and 47.2% humidity. Much better now. Close enough for my needs. Mission accomplished. This little guy does the job, though it needed a touch of calibration to get there. Chapter 6. Final thoughts. The SONOFF SNZB-02P is compact, reasonably accurate, especially after calibration, and overall surprisingly good. Here is what I love. Solid build quality, clean modern design, magnetic back, and multiple mounting options. Battery life? The manual claims 4 years. Reality? Better than expected. I have 5 of these sensors in my Zigbee network. 2 of them have been running since December 2023, constantly reporting temperature and humidity with 0 issues, and they're still showing 100% battery. That's genuinely impressive. To keep track, I've added battery levels for all temperature and humidity sensors to my Home Assistant dashboard, along with their location, model, and the month and year each one was powered and paired to the Zigbee network. I've also tagged the SNZB-02P sensors with a red indicator for easy identification. Now, for the downsides, some calibration may be required out of the box, which can take a bit of time. Unfortunately, the SNZB-02P doesn't appear in my OTA list, so firmware updates can't be pushed remotely at the time of this review. But all things considered, if you're looking for a budget-friendly and reliable way to monitor temperature and humidity, this little sensor is a solid investment. I'd rate it a solid 8 out of 10. Chapter 7. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching. I truly appreciate you spending your time with me. Whether you're just getting started with Home Assistant, or you've been automating your smart home for years, if you enjoyed this video or found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, or share it with someone who might benefit too. It really helps the channel grow and keeps the content coming. If you'd like to go one step further and support the channel directly, you can buy me a coffee or send a tip via PayPal. Every contribution, big or small, goes straight into making even better tutorials, guides, and reviews. Your support means the world. It helps us keep the lights on, literally and smartly, and fuels the creation of more great content. You'll find all the links in the description just below this video. Thanks again, and I'll see you in the next one. Happy monitoring!